In other words, with this Willie Crick Dam coming up, the man who goes to the Senate and takes Sam Foley's place can't ask any questions or talk out of turn. We've got to be absolutely sure of him.
A ranger, a squirrel chaser to the United States Senate?
Listen, Jim, a simpleton of all times, a big-eyed patriot, knows Lincoln and Washington by heart.
Do you really think you can handle this whatchamacallem in Washington? Do you think it's all right?
I think it's all right.
I can promise you one thing. I'll do nothing to disgrace the office of the United States Senate. That's just the point. There are 100 other places in the state that really need the water. And besides, I talked to Kenneth Allen, who owns some of that land up there. He didn't say anything about a dam. No, sir. Now, doggone it, there's something wrong here. I know there's something wrong. And I'm not going to vote on that thing until I get some more questions answered.
What do you want me to do? Stand around like you chumps and let that drooling infant wrap that Willow Creek dam appropriation around my neck? Not me. Either he falls in line with us and behaves himself, or I'll break him so wide open they'll never be able to find the pieces. You know, some people told me that you were dumb. I think you're smart. In fact, I think you're smart enough to understand a situation when it's explained to you.
Likewise, sir.
Well, for instance, building a dam on Willard Creek.
Just what's your interest in this, Mr. Taylor?
What's my interest? Well, anything that benefits the state is mighty important to me. Owning a lot of its industry, newspapers, and other odds and ends. Now, if I felt that you had the welfare of the state at heart like I have, I'd say you were a man to watch. Now, what do you like? Business? If you like business, you can pick any job in the state and go right to the top. Or politics. Huh? If you like being a senator, there's no reason why you can't come back to that Senate and stay there as long as you want to. If you're smart.
Now, you've been living in a boy's world, Jeff, and for heaven's sake, stay there. This is a man's world. It's a brutal world, Jeff, and you've no place in it. You'll only get hurt. Now, take my advice. Forget Taylor and what he said. Forget you ever heard of the Willard Creek Dam.
Mr. President, I have risen to a difficult task. To say that out of evidence that has come to my attention, I consider Senator Smith unworthy to address this body.
What are you going to believe in? When a man like Payne, Senator Joseph Payne, gets up and swears that I've been robbing kids of nickels and dimes. A man I've admired and worshipped all my life. I don't know. A lot of fancy words around this town. Some of them are carved in stone. Some of them... I guess the Taylors and Paynes put them up there so suckers like me could read them. And then when you find out what men actually do, I'm getting out of this town so fast and away from all the words and the monuments and the whole rotten show.
I see. When you get home, what are you going to tell those kids?
Well, I'll tell them the truth. Might as well find it out now as later.
I don't think they'll believe you, Jeff. You know, they're liable to look up at you with hurt faces and say, Jeff, what did you do? Quit? Didn't you do something about it?
Well, what do you expect me to do? An honorary stooge like me against the Taylors and Paynes and machines and lies.
Your friend Mr. Lincoln had his Taylors and Paynes. So did every other man who ever tried to lift his thought up off the ground. Odds against him didn't stop those men. They were fools that way. All the good that ever came into this world came from fools with faith like that. You know that, Jeff. You can't quit now. Not you. They aren't all Taylors and Paynes in Washington. That kind just throw big shadows, that's all. You didn't just have faith in Payne or any other living man. You had faith in something bigger than that. You had plain, decent, everyday, common rightness. And this country could use some of that. Yeah, so could the whole cockeyed world. A lot of it. Remember the first day you got here? Remember what you said about Mr. Lincoln? You said he was sitting up there waiting for someone to come along? You were right. He was waiting for a man who could see his job and sail into it. That's what he was waiting for. A man who could tear into the Taylors and root them out into the open. I think he was waiting for you, Jeff. He knows you can do it. So do I.
And this same man, Mr. James Taylor, came down here and offered me a seat in this Senate for the next 20 years if I voted for a dam that he knew and I knew was a fraud. But if I dared to open my mouth against that dam, he promised to break me in two. All right, I got up here and I started to open my mouth, and the long and powerful arm of Mr. James Taylor reached into this sacred chamber and grabbed me by the scruff of the neck. There's no compromise with truth. That's all I got up on this floor to say. There's no place out there for graft or greed or lies or compromise with human liberties. And it's not too late. Because this country is bigger than the Taylors, or you, or me, or anything else. Great principles don't get lost once they come to light. They're right here.